Last session, we had a discussion about, have you remembered, right? We had a discussion about certain decorators, and even I started generators concept also. I hope you may remember, right? Yes, decorators and then generators are the most terrible topics for most of the people. Anyway, I tried my level best to inject in your mind. Are you getting? So, decorator, what is the purpose of decorator? Okay, decorator is always going to take some function as input function, and it's going to provide output function with extended behavior. Sir, without modifying existing functionality, happily we are allowed to, sir, extend the functionality. Okay, how it is possible, sir? By using decorator's concept. I hope, have you remembered, right? We covered somewhere already, right? Decorator is always going to take some input function as argument. Are you getting, right? So decorator is always going to take, sir, some input function as argument, and it is always going to produce some output function as output, sir. So this input function and the output function, what is the difference between these two things, right? This output function is extended function. I mean the function with the extended functionality by default considered as a decorator, right? Who is doing this job? Decorator by default is going to do this job. I hope everyone can able to understand, right? What the decorators are? Decorator is a function. This decorator function is always going to take some input function as the argument, and it's going to provide output functions. So the main purpose of decorator function is to extend the existing functionality without modifying sir that function. If you want already existing functionality, I can extend with some other name. That thing is nothing but what? That is the job of decorator, right? Sir, I hope everyone in a position to understand, right? What is the decorator? Sir, I hope already I covered complete one session. We spend only on decorator concept, right? Next term, decorator chaining. Are you getting decorator chaining? Is it possible, sir, to chain, to define multiple decorators for the same function or not? Yes, man, why not? Happily, it's always possible. No problem at all. Sir, yesterday we had a bigger doubt related to this, sir, is it top to bottom or is it bottom to top? Which one is the correct answer? Yes, believe me, all the decorators are going to work from bottom to top only. Sorry, from top to bottom only. Okay, from top to first one, second one, third one, like it's going to work. But the execution is always in the reverse. How, sir? How this one is going to be happened? Anyone analyze it? Yes, yesterday we stuck somewhere, decorator chaining. Anyone analyze that? Hey, respond, man. Anyone analyze it? Yesterday decorator chaining, already we discussed that somewhere we got stuck. Sometimes top to bottom, sometimes bottom to top. Next and after that, sir, what only which method executed only once, but two decorators are there, it has to execute two times, right? Some people may feel like, sir, have you remembered? Anyone analyzed that? Yes, just have a look once, sir. Don't worry about that, sir. Sir, I'm taking def of function here. Just I'm just taking a legend. More concentration must be required, sir. This decorator itself is nothing but a bit dangerous concept, sir. Decorators and generators, sir, you should aware. Actually, it is not going to be discussed in the functions concept. Somewhere a bit advanced level we require to discuss, but anyway, it's a good time. Okay, even you can able to understand, right? Sir, now I have which function is there, sir. Assume that which function is there. Assume that print of, sir, print of hello. Hello, name, good morning. Like this I'm taking, sir. Hello, name, good morning. Like this I'm taking. Sir, if I call wish function by passing some name as the argument. Okay, name I'm passing as Durga. I got a name I'm passing as Durga. Durga like this. Can you please tell what is the output by default you are going to get, sir? Perfectly, this function by default is going to execute, sir. Remember this one. Perfectly, this function by default is going to execute, no problem at all. Are you getting that? Hello, Durga, good morning, like this. Suppose if I call Vishop Sunny, like this I'm taking, sir. Vishop Sunny, like this I'm taking. Now, hello, Sunny. Good morning. Like this, it's going to get. Sir, my requirement is I want to change the functionality. I want to extend this functionality, sir. If it is Durga, if the name is Durga, okay, no problem, sir. Provide now. Sir, if name is Sunny, can you please provide hello, bad morning, hello Sunny, bad morning, something like. So instead of this common wish statement, what I want to do, sir, if it is a Sunny, different message. If it is not Sunny, same message I want to display. Are you getting right? So I don't want to change this functionality because this functionality already developed by some X person. How I can extend this functionality based on my requirement? For that, we should go for decorators concept. Are you in a position to understand, right? Sir, we should go for which concept, sir? Decorators concept. We should go for that. How you can able to do that, sir? Just a matter of 1 minute. Have a look once, sir. Don't feel already covered. Just better to bring into the sink. Okay. Can you please guide, sir? How I can define decorator? DEF decor. Can you spell out, sir? DEF decor. Decor function is always going to take some function as argument. Next one after that, DEF inner function. Inner function is going to take some name. If name is equal to Sunny. Are you getting? If name is equal to Sunny, what I want to take, sir? Here, you know, just a print. Hello, Sunny. Bad morning. Are you getting? Hello, Sunny. Bad morning. Like this, I want to print, sir. Sir, else. What I want to do, just you can call directly function by passing name as the argument. Are you getting right? Now you require to return this inner function. Are you getting? You require to return this inner function. So I defined some decorator. Sir, now actually Vishmeda is always going to print only one type. Hello, Sunny, good morning. Hello, Durga, good morning. But I want to extend this functionality. If the name is a Sunny, if the name is Sunny, then automatically hello Sunny, bad morning, something like it has to print. Are you getting that? Okay, sir. Next, else we require to take sir, just call the function. Now take very, very special care about this terminology, right? Okay, make sure, sir, you people should be aware very clearly, right, sir. Now here observe a bit very, very carefully about this one, sir. How I can link these two things at the rate decor, like this line, sir. Now take very special care. What will happen is whenever we are calling wish method, then a bit very carefully, sir, whenever we are calling wish method, is there any decorator is defined or not? Oh, decorator is defined, man. Immediately this decorator will be executed and it's going to return some function. That function by default is going to be executed, right? Are you getting? That function by default is going to be executed, inner function. Now inner, sir, this is the function. So which function is the argument, sir? Anyone, can you please tell, sir? Our wish itself is argument. This function is nothing but, sir, wish is always going to take. Now this is the new function. This new function is going to be returned. Remember that this new function is going to be returned. This return the function is going to be executed. Remember that this return the function inner is going to be executed whenever we are calling wish method. Are you able to understand, right, sir? If a decorator is defined, whenever we are calling wish method, immediately my Python is going to check is there any decorator is defined for this. Yes, ma'am, there is some decorator defined for that. Immediately, sir, by passing this wish as the argument, sir, wish as the argument, this inner is going to return. Simply inner function is going to be executed. But for the inner function, FUNC means which function? Respond. FUNC means which function? Which is the FUNC, sir? Sir, this wish function. That's why make sure, sir. I hope everyone can able to understand. Just link the things you people should be aware. So here, have you observed this wish sir, which will become argument to, which will become argument to decar, decar. Okay, like, sir, whenever you are calling this one, instead of this which function, it is going to call this function. Okay, this inner function is going to be executed. Here, name means whatever the argument for the which, that one will become argument. Sir, can you please tell what is the answer by default we are going to get? Please respond. What is the answer by default we are going to get? Respond, man. Can you please tell what is the answer by default we are going to get? Wish of Durga. Hello, Durga. Good morning. Hello, Durga. Good morning. That's all. So, hello, Durga. Good morning. Like this, we are going to get, sir. Now, Abjad. Hello, Durga. 1 minute. 1 minute. Just not safe. Okay. Hello, Durga. Good morning by default we are going to get. Suppose my requirement is, let me go for Sunny. Are you getting? Let me go for Sunny. Sunny. Now, Can you please observe? Hello, Sunny. Bad morning. Sir, hello, Durga. Good morning. Like, sir, my decorator executing properly or not? Yes. Any explanation is required? My decorator is executing properly or not? Yes. No problem at all, sir. Sir, now take very, 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 very special care. Here for the decorator, which function is the input, sir? For the decorator, which function is the input, sir? Suppose this is my decorator. Assume that this is my decorator, sir. Assume it is my decorator, sir. Assume that it is the decorator. Sir, this decorator is always going to take which one as the input, sir? Which is always going to consider, yes, input. Now this person is going to provide some output. That output is nothing but inner function. Clear? Not required to keep any explanation about this terminology, right? Okay, make sure. Now I have one small doubt, sir. Sir, here have a look once. Can you please tell what is the output we are going to get? Hey, respond. More concentration must be required. Sir, what is the output by default we are going to get? I defined a big code I wrote, man. 11 lines of the code I wrote. What is the output by default you are going to get? No output. Because what is the reason? You are not calling that function. Are you getting? We are not calling that function. Okay, that's why. What is the output by default you are going to get, sir? No output at all. Are you getting? There is no output at all. Okay, well. Sir, yesterday, now I hope you are in the sync with what is decorator? What is the decorator like? So, already some function is there. To extend its functionality without modifying this function. Sir, which is always available. Without modifying this function, I want to extend its functionality. Then we can go for what? Decorator concept. Okay, decorators is a beautiful concept available in the Python. Everyone can aware? Sir, all the people who are there in the class, are the sync with the concept or not? Yes. Sir, now take a bit very, very special care about my terminology, sir. What is the important conclusion here is, take a bit very special care. Sir, if is it possible to define multiple decorators or not? Yes, sir. Yes. Such type of concept is nothing but decorator chaining. Okay, if the decorator chaining is there, in which order the decorators are going to be executed. Sir, you should have clarity, right? It is the more dangerous concept, sir. Make sure it is always going to execute from top to bottom. Yesterday, two examples I covered. Sir, sometimes I'm seeing from top to bottom. Sometimes I'm seeing bottom to top. Correct? Two examples I covered. One time, top to bottom, but second time, bottom to top. No. Remember fixed rule. It's always going to be considered from top to bottom. Okay? How, sir? In what way we can decide? Very simple. Let me take same, again, decorator concept. Observe that, sir. This is my wish function. Now I want to define def decor one. Legend, a bit very carefully, sir. Function, like this I'm taking, sir. Sir, now def decor one, okay, function. Can you please tell, please guide, sir, def inner, it's always going to take some name as the argument, print decorator one, executing, like this I'm taking, sir. Next, return in, here decorator, next one after that, can you please call function of name? Are you getting? Can you please call function of name? Sir, now return inner. Okay, like, sir, very, very dangerous concept. Make sure not that much easy to understand. More concentration must be required. Okay. Now, here, take a bit very special care. At the rate, the car one, I'm taking, sir. At the rate, the car one. Sir, whenever we are calling, wish me that by passing some name at the argument, can you please tell decorator is going to be executed or not? Yes, ma'am. Decorator is going to be executed or not? Yes, why not? Happily, decorator got executed. Sir, here, unindignant. Here, which line? Line number four. 1, 2, 3, 4. Am I doing any mistake? No, right? Function of name, and then return inner line. Why it is showing some problem? One minute. Decor, DF. Decorator executing. Like this, I'm taking. 1 minute, sir. 1 minute. Maybe. Function name. Function of name. Correct, right? Correct. I'm calling function of name. That's all. Next, and after that, return inner like this. Yes. Now, perfectly, decorator one executing, no problem at all. Sir, well, now take a bit very special care. Whenever we are calling wish function, legend, this type of analysis must be required. Immediately, decorator is defined or not? Wait, decorator is defined or not? Yes. This decorator is going to take wish function as the argument. This decorator is going to return which one, sir? Array, this decorator is going to return which one? Inner function. Now, sir, here what will happen is, whenever we are calling wish method, this inner function is going to be executed. Remember this one. This inner function is going to be executed. Inside inner function, if anywhere FUNC, can you please tell what is the input for this decorator? What is the input function for this decorator? Respond. What is the input function for this decorator? Wish. Remember this one. What is the input for this decorator? Wish. Wish itself is the input function for this decorator. That's why, sir, inside this inner function, whenever you are calling, sir, function name, which one is going to execute? Wish. That's why, whenever we are calling wish, decorator is defined. This decorator returns inner function. That's why inner function is going to execute. So inner, first this line will be printed. And then it is going to call function of name. Function of FUNC means wish. Wish of name will be executed. Hello, Durga. Good morning is the next line. So first line and the second line by default we are going to get. So perfectly the corresponding output is like this. Okay, well. Sir, now, can you please tell how many decorators are available here? Respond. Very important. How many decorators are available? One. What is the input argument for this decorator? What is the input? Input argument for this decorator? Function. Function means which one? Which function? Wish function. Remember that, sir. Wish function. Wish function is the argument. Excellent, man. Now, legend. Let me start our cinema. DEF decor 2, sir. DEF decor 2 function. Now DEF inner of name I'm taking. Print of decorator 2 executing. Now FUNC of name I'm passing. Next, what I'm taking, sir? Return inner. Okay, like. Now, at the rate decor 2, sir. Yesterday, the cinema starts here only. So, Rich Cohen already commenting, sir, confusion starts. No, nothing, man. That was yesterday's problem. Today, everything is going to be clear. Believe me, Rich Cohen. Don't worry. Because I did already the required thing. Slowly, I'm keeping in touch with you. You people are already nearer to that. No confusion. Just legend, that's all. Now take very, very special care, sir. Very, very special care. Decorator 2, decorator 1, and then wish function. Can you please tell total how many functions are available? respond man, total how many functions are available? Only this input function is always wish. Now for the decorator one, which one is the input? Yes, wish is the input. For the decorator one, which function is the inputs are? Wish is the input. Decorator one, whenever you are calling decorator one, this inner function is going to execute. Within this inner function, anywhere function you are using means wish is the function. Up to this, any doubt? Yes, man. This part, is it clear, right? So whenever I'm calling this decorator one, internally it is going to return inner. This inner function is going to execute. Within the inner function, FUNC means, FUNC means wish. For effect, not required to keep any explanation. Clear, right? Yes, man. Up to this is the clear for all of you, right? Next, take very, very special care. Whenever we are taking decor 2, are you getting? Whenever we are taking decor 2, for the decor 2, which one is the input function? The input function is not wish function. Remember this one, sir. The input function is not a wish function. So which one is the input? The output of decor one will become input. Remember this one, sir. So for the decor two, which one is the input? Output of decor one will become input. Best example, sir. Legend this one. Suppose legend a bit very carefully, sir. Suppose there is one very cute lady is there, or cute gent is there, sir. So tomorrow is the marriage. Assume that, sir, tomorrow itself is the marriage and so on. Sir, now some decoration must be required. Okay, first she or he is going to approach, sir, first decorator. There these people are going to take care hair related all the decoration. Assume now hair decoration already completed. After hair decoration, now the next cinema is going to start. Face decoration will start. Remember this one. Assume that next one is face decoration. Now this original person is the input to hair decorator, but which one is the input to surface decorator? Not this original person. For this original person, already hair decoration completed, that hair decorated function will become input to the face decorator. Are you able to understand, right? Are you first level already completed? Now already completed, the first level function will become argument to second decorator. Are you able to understand? Yes, man. Don't concentrate on my diagram, concentrate on topic. are you able to understand, right? Okay, sir, make sure, sir. Now observe a bit very carefully, right, sir? Now first, sir, for the decor one, which one is the input function? Yes, sir, respond. For decor one, which one is the input function? Wish function. For decor two, which one is the input function? Anyone, can you please tell? Good. For decor two, which one is the input function? Decor one return inner function will become input. Remember, sir, for the decor two, wish is not input. For all these were decorator, only this wish is the input and so on. No, there are multiple decorators are working. That's why compulsory. So first this one, it is going to return. That return value by default will become input to this person. Any explanation is required? Yes, ma'am. Are you in a position to understand slowly? Yes, something. Are you getting only one point, sir? For decor one, which one is the input function? Please respond. For decor one, which one is the input function? Input function is always what? Wish function. For decor two, which one is the input function? Decor one return. Decor one is going to return inner function. This inner function will become argument or input to this decor two. Now my question is, take very, very special care, sir. Just 2 minutes. If you are going to get to that point, nothing is there, sir. Now observe, sir, for decor one, which one is the input function? Please respond. decar 1, which one is the input function? Yes, man, decar 1, which one is the input function? Which function? Which function, right? So whenever we are taking decar 1, internally this one is going to execute. Decar 1, internally this function is going to execute. Now my question is, for decar 1, which one is the input? Please respond, which one is the input? Wish. Inside this inner function, if anywhere you are talking wish, then automatically which function is going to come, sir? Okay, which function by default is FENC, means which function is going to come in the picture. Okay, well, for decar 2, which one is the input function? For decar 2, which one is the input function? Input function. Yes, sir. This decar 1 returned the inner function. Sir, this decar 1 returned inner function will become input to decar 2, sir. So remember that. That is the only one line you have to get extra. If you feel comfortable, then I will tell the exact flow. Sir, clear for all of you, right? Sir, total how many decorators are there? Are you getting total how many decorators are there? Two decorators, right? But how many main functions are available? Only one function. Sir, very simple. You can able to understand within a minute. Just observe that, sir. Observe that. Matter of 1 minute, please. Sir, there is one person is there. Assume that there is one person is there, sir. Assume he went to the job selection process. First written test completed. After completing written test, next group discussion. After completing group discussion, next sir technical round. After completing technical round, HR round. After completing HR round, now final selection. Are you getting right? Final selection. This is, I hope you can able to understand easily, sir. Sir, now what is the input to written test? All the people who came, all the people will become input to written test. But what is the input to group discussion? What is the input to group discussion? The output of written test will become input to group discussion. Sir, what is the input to technical round? The output of group discussion will become input to. But don't feel that, sir, all the people are going to attend written test, all the people are going to attempt group discussion, all the people are going to attend a technical interview. No such type of terminology. First, written test, filter. Now the output, whatever you are going to get, that output will become input to group discussion. Sir, whatever input you are going to get because of group discussion, whatever output you are going to get because of group discussion will become input to next round. Now, I hope, are you in a position to understand? Please, is it okay, right? is the HR person is always going to take, sir, the input from technical round. Assume that, sir. So in general, that is a sequence by default. Every company having some sequence. First written test, next technical round, next group discussion, something like that. That depends. But previous round output will become input to next round. It is a very common thing. Sir, same way, sir, for decar 1, which is the input. For decar 2, decar 1 output will become input, right? Okay. Now, sir, more time we spend. Now, let me go for process, right? Sir, now, decar 2 is going to execute. Take very, very special care, sir. Decar 2, first, which one came? Who respond? First, which one came? Array, first, which one came? Decar 2. Decar 2 is coming, sir. Decar 2 is coming. That's why, immediately, decar 2 has to execute. But immediately decar 2 has to execute. Now take very special care. Decar 2 returns inner. Oh, this inner by default is going to get in the chance. Whenever we are calling wish method, immediately this inner by default is going to execute by passing name as the argument. That's why here print a decorator to execute a first line. Remember this one, sir, first line. But now the control is inside decar 2. For the decar 2, which one is the input? respond. For decar 2, which one is the input? Input is always decar 1 output. So whenever you are calling function inside a decar 2, this one is nothing but decar 1 related function. Is it clear for all of you? Decar 1 related function. Decar 1 related function is nothing but this one is going to execute. Observe that. Observe the flow. Here that, sir. If you are going to get nothing, is there, sir? Let me repeat once again. Please, let me repeat once again so that you will get much clarity. Nothing. Sir, now observe. First, which is going to execute? Decar 2. Remember that, decar 2. Immediately, whenever you are calling which function, observe very carefully, sir. Whenever we are calling which function, first, which decar is there? Decar 2. Immediately, the control will go to decar 2, sir. Immediately, the control will go to decar 2. Decar 2 returns inner. That's why this inner function is going to execute. Because this is the inner function of decar 2, which is the output of decar 2, it's going to execute. But make sure, sir. So it is the print. First line is going to be printed. One is decorator 2 executed. Well, sir, which one is the input to decar 2? Please respond. Which one is the input to decar 2? The decar 2 input is nothing but, sir, output of decar 1. Output of decar 1. Output of decar 1 is nothing but this one. Okay, this one. So whenever you are calling function, means decar 1 inner is going to come. Decar 1 inner is going to come. Because for decar 2 function means what? Decar 1. That's why immediately decar 1 related inner is going to execute. Now decorator 1 executing. Next, inside this decar 1 inner, if I can use function, what is the input function to the decar 1? Wish is the input function. That's why. So wish of name, which name I am passing, sir? Durga. Now final wish, hello Durga, good morning, is going to execute. This is the third one. If you people can able to think, then you can able to understand what they're inside. Yes, man. Are you able to understand? Sir, flow is always from top to bottom. Remember that. Flow is always from top to bottom. Remember, because inside the decar, because of this function call, it is going to execute like this. That's why it is always, if this function call is not there, then this one is not going to execute, man. Remember that. Then it's not going to execute. Okay, now let me execute first. Can you please tell what is the output we are going to get now? What is the output we are going to get if everything is going to be happening according to our discussion? What is the output by default we are going to get? First, decorator 2, and after that, decorator 1, and after that, sir, hello name, good morning, hello Durga, good morning. Like, now have a look once. Decorator 2, decorator 1, and then hello Durga, good morning, like this. Clear? Clear, sir. Still, how many people are having the doubt? Still, how many people are having the doubt? Decar 1 executed, man. If the decar 1 is not going to execute, then how it is going to print? Yes, Rishi, good. Any other person? Anyone having the doubt? Please, it's a matter of few minutes. Don't worry, sir, because it's a very terrible topic. Yes. Okay, now, yes, good. Now at least the remaining people who are having the doubt, can you please legend very carefully, sir? Now what I want to take, legend this one. Now I'm taking one, now I'm taking two. Now I'm taking one, and now I'm taking two, sir. Just now I changed the order. Please observe a bit carefully. I will explain freshly so that the people who didn't get, at least try to get. Can you please tell, I have very, very quick questions. Sir, whenever you are calling which method, definitely decar 1 and decar 2 will be executed and so on. For decar 2, which is the input function? For decar 2, which is the input function? Wish. Excellent. Especially the people who are having the doubt, please respond. For decar 2, which is the input function? 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 for decar 1, which is the input function? Decar 1, which is the input function? Return value of decar 2. Okay, return value of decar 2 will become input to decar 1. Okay, well, sir. Now, first, which one is good, sir? Take very special care. The people who didn't get, please. Sir, first, decar 1 is going to execute. So, whenever we are calling Vishmeda, sir, first which decorator you define? Decar 1. That's why decar 1 is going to execute. Decar 1 means this one, this is the inner. Now it is going to be executed. That's why first this one. So what is the output we are going to get now? Decorator 1 executing first. So now for decar 1, which one is the input function? Input function is, sir, decar 2 output. Decar 2 will become input function. Decar 2 will become input function. That's why inside the sir decar 1, if you call function, this function is always going to refer decar 2. Now, sir, the control will goes to sir decar 2 related input function. So this one is going to be executed. Because of this call, these two things are going to be executed. Now, this is the second line. For the decar 2, which one is the input function? Wish is the input function. For decar 2, which is the input function? Wish. So, if you call function of name, wish function, automatically the control is coming to wish. Hello, Durga. Good morning. Like this. Clear? Anyone, can you please tell what is the output by default you are going to get? What is the output by default you are going to get? Yes, first D1 and then D2 and then hello, good morning, something like this we are going to get. Everyone can able to understand, right? Okay, just still one or two members may have the doubt. Don't worry, sir. Just wait for a minute, sir. Now I'm taking one more example I'm taking so that you may get. Sir, yesterday we covered, sir, I have a number function is there. That number function is going to return x into x, one decorator, another one is going to take double. Now you can able to understand very easily. Let me take, sir. I have num function is there, return 10. That's all. It's not going to just return simply 10. That's all. This is the number function what I have. Now I'm taking def decar 1. Just I'm taking double decar of FUNC, DEF inner. Okay, very simple, sir. X is equal to, sir, FUNC. Now I have to return X double, right? 2 into X, just double the value. Sir, x is function means num. Okay, next, after that return inner, like this something. Yeah, wonderful, sir. I hope you can able to understand. Now if I call at the rate double decar, like now print of num, sir, if I'm not taking this, what is the answer? If I'm not taking decar, what is the answer? Simply 10 is the answer. 10 is the answer. If I can take decar, what is the answer? 20 is the answer. Perfectly, my decar is working or not? Double decar is working. Now my requirement is, okay. Now same DEF square decar. Square decar of FUNC, inner, I'm taking df of inner, x is equal to FUNC, return x into x, return inner. Sir, now here that's all. instead of course, you know already both the things are going to work. Now I'm taking square decar, next and after that, double decar, square decar. Now take very, very special care. Sir, any explanation is required? Can you please guess what the answer we are going to get now? Yes. What the answer we are going to get now? Please respond. Hey, only one output we are going to get. Why you are getting these many outputs, man? Govinda. Only one output by default we are going to get, man. Only one output we are going to get. Why? After applying all the decorators, the last final output has to get. Okay. Well, sir, legend. At least the people who didn't get or the people who are having the doubt, please legend, sir. Sir, this is my base function. What is the function name? What is the function name? Num. Num is the function name. For this num, how many decars I'm defining? How many decars I'm defining? Two decars. One is double decar. Second one is the square decar. So for the square decar, which is the input? Which is the input function? Hey, square decar, which is the input function? Input function num. Num. Num is the input function. So if you are going to execute square decar, so this function is going to execute. Inside that, if you call func, definitely it is always going to call this one only, because it is the input to square decar. Well, what is the input to double decar? What is the input to double decar? Please respond. Input to double decar. Sir, the return of square decar. Return of square decar. This one will become input to double decar. Input to double decar. Is it okay? Up to this, any doubt? Okay, up to this, any doubt? Now, have a look. I'm ready to go for the program execution. Now, listen carefully. Whenever you are calling number, immediately my Python is going to check either any decorators are defined. Oh, multiple. Now, Python is always going to execute from top to bottom. Okay, like first, anyway, first double decar. Oh, first double decar. Double decar is going to return this inner. That's why these two lines should be executed. These two lines should be executed like. Sir, but for the double decar, if I call FUNC, can you please tell what is the function? FUNC. FUNC means what is the function? Which one is going to execute, sir? Which one is going to execute? Which one is going to execute? For the double decar, FUNC means, sir, square decar input. That's why whenever you are calling this function, the control will go to this function. Because it is the input to double decar. X is equal to FUNC. Sir, for the square decar, which one is the input, sir? Num is the input. That's why X value will become, sir, 10. 10 is the X value. Return X into X. What is the X into X, sir? 10. 10 into 10 is nothing but in this line, 100 will be returned. Are you getting? X will become 100. Because this inner function of square decar is going to return 100. Okay, well. Sir, after this, return 2 into X. 2 into X value is nothing but 100. That 200 is going to be returned. That 200 I'm going to print. Clear? Are you able to understand? No response, man. Okay? Now, have a look once. What is the answer by default you are getting? 200 perfectly. Yes, Rich Cohen, and then Rishi. Now are you getting clarity? Yes, Rich Cohen, are you getting clarity? Okay, now, Vedant Tiwari, your doubt is, sir, why original function number return 10 is never obtained? Because you define decorators, man. Once you arrange a decorator output only we are always going to get. Decorator output we are going to get. But not original function. Okay, if you want to call original function also, there is some way I told in the last session, you can. Okay, now, sir, suppose I want to interchange this, please. Last one, I don't want to tell any more, even you are asking the doubt also, legend. Sir, now can you please tell what the output, sir? I don't guess, or otherwise don't perform mathematical operations. Observe the flow, so that you can get much clarity. Regarding, now, how many decorators are there? How many decorators are there? Two decorators, right? But the first one square decor, second one double decor. Now take a bit very special care. Square decor. What is the input to double decor? What is the input function to double decor? I don't want the output, man. What is the input to double decor? Num function. What is the input to square decor? Input to square decor. The return type of double decor. Okay. Now, sir, whenever you are calling num function, now observe, whenever you are calling num function, immediately the control will go to decors. Because decors are defined, first decor is going to be executed. Whenever we are taking first decor means a square decor. Square decor, sir, inner function is going to be executed. Remember that. So for the square decor, inner function means, what is the input, sir? Double decor. That's why x is equal to FUNC. FUNC means what? Double decor. Now immediately, this inner is going to execute. X is equal to function. For this double decor, which one is the function, sir? Num. That's why x is equal to function means num 10. So x value 10 you are going to get. Return 2 into 10 is nothing but 20. So this 20 by default is going to come. Sir, x value will become 20. Now return x into x. 20 into 20. What about its values are 400. Are you getting? 400 by default we have to get. Clear? That's all. This is about, okay, decorator chaining. Remember that. You can define any number of decorators, no problem at all. Logic is always the same. Are you getting? Don't ask me to explain with 4 or 5 decors. Are you getting? Yes. Sir, clear for all of you, right? Okay, make sure, sir. So, how many times the base function is always going to execute? Only once, sir. But decorators are going to execute multiple times. Remember that. Okay. Now, clear. After this, that's all. So now, return inner means first it will get the return value. I mean, return inner function. That inner function internally going to execute. So first, it will call square decor. Square decor is going to return some inner. That inner function will be executed. That's why compulsory inner must be required. Return inner. Why I'm taking? Whenever you are taking, like, immediately square decor is going to execute. Square decor is going to return some inner function. That inner function is going to execute means these two lines will execute. Rich Cohen, are you getting the doubt? Okay. After 2020, return inner. Yeah, this one you are talking, right? Yes. Okay. That's answer. Anyway, this is. Which one is supposed to execute twice, man? I didn't get. Rich Cohen. Which one is required to execute twice? Inner is going to execute, sir. Just last time I'm going to explain. Cohen, you have to listen very carefully. That's all. You have to listen a bit very carefully, sir. Now observe that. observe a bit very carefully, sir. So now take a bit very special care. Okay, in your perspective, I'm going to explain. Please listen a bit very carefully, sir. Here, listen a bit carefully. Whenever you are calling number, immediately, sir, my Python is going to execute num only. But for this num, decorators are defined. That's why decorator, will be executed. Which one is the first decorator? Square decor. Whenever square decor, square decor function is going to execute, sir, bypassing which one is the argument, sir? The argument is double decor input. Okay, sir, it is going to return inner. So which inner is going to return? This inner. That's why. So that inner function will be executed because this double decor returns this inner function. Are you getting? This is the inner. Now the control immediately coming to this one. Are you getting? So if the return inner is not there, then meaningless decorator function is not going to work. Return inner, because of that inner function is going to execute. Okay, well, now inside this inner, x is equal to FUMC. Sir, for the double decor, for the double, so one minute. First square decor, right? And then double decor. Okay, now observe this. Now observe this one, sir. Okay, just have a. What is that? Rich Cohen, are you okay? Do you want me to execute again? Do you want me to explain again? Yeah, sir, that's all the people, remaining people got, or do you want me to explain last time? Very, very important. Very important, dangerous, terrible topic is the decorator's concept. Make sure, sir. Okay, yeah. Last one, last time I'm going to explain, still the people are asking a bit of doubt, sir. Take a bit very special care. Sir, very simple, sir. Very simple, don't think too much. I will simplify the terminology. Sir, this is our base function. Sir, whenever you are executing, if any person is calling this one, better to call these decorator functions. Are you getting? Because this num functionality is extended, man. Num functionality is extended. That's why. So num functionality is extended by double decor. That double decor extended by square decor. Observe this. Better to think in this perspective, sir, so that you will get that clearly. Sir, what is our original function? Please respond. What is our original function? Num is the original function. Num is extended by, num functionality is extended by double decor. Rich Cohen, observe in this way. So double decor, this num decor extended by double decor extended by square decor. Regarding double decor functionality extended by square decor. Okay, like now whenever you call num, so topmost extended functionality is available where? Topmost extended functionality is available where? Can you please tell? Num is extended by double decor. This double decor functionality extended by square decor. That's why topmost extended functionality available where, sir? Please respond. Topmost extended functionality is available where? Ayo. Let me repeat. Very, very important. Please listen. Sir, what is the original function? What is the original function? Num. Num is my original function. Legend, last time I'm going to explain num. What is the this num functionality extended by double decor? Are you getting extended by double decor? Now, this double decor functionality extended by square decor. So finally, which one we require to execute, sir? Square decor is required to execute. But for the square decor, double decor will become input. For double decor, num will become input. Remember this one, sir. So finally, ultimate extended functionality available where, sir? With the square decor. That's why if you execute square decor, our job by default is going to be completed. Okay, getting? Now immediately the control will goes to square decor. Okay, where is the square decor, sir? This is, sir, square decor return inner. Oh, this inner function we require to execute, means this is the function. But now my question is, For the square decad, which one is the input? Which one is the input? Double decad is the input. That's why this function means double decad is the input. Inside the square decad, if I call function, immediately the control will go to double decad. Okay, double decad return this in, that's why it is going to execute. But for the double decad, what is the FUNC means? Wish, num. That's why here x is equal to num. What is the num value? 10. This return 2 into 10 means 20. 20. Now this function will return 20. Now return x into x. 20 into 20 is nothing but what? 40. Like this, right? So now print of num is nothing but 400 by default I have to get. Are you getting? Now have a look once. 400 by default you are going to get. Clear, right? Okay, that's all. Sir, make sure, sir. So now here original function. Num functionality extended by double decad. Double decad functionality extended by square decad. So that's why whenever you are calling num, you require to execute square decad. Okay, that's all. Whenever you are executing square decad, compulsory at the input double decad is required. Whenever you are extending double decad, compulsory num must be required. Are you getting? This is something like, yes, this is something like, okay, square decad of double decad of num, something like, okay, like this one. So num will become input to double decad will become input to square decad. So that's why whenever you are calling square decad, internally double decad will execute. Double decad internally calls num. So total extended functionality by default you are going to get, sir. Okay, sir. Still the people who are having the doubt, what I have to do is, you have to analyze with pleasant mind, then you can able to get that. Okay, that's all. No other explanation. So now that is, now what is the next cinema we have to talk, sir? What is the next one we require to talk? Take a bit very, very special care about this one, sir. Okay, sir, now generators concept. Even we covered yesterday, generators concept. Normal collections and generators. What is the difference? Normal collections and generators. What is the difference? Normal collection, the values are always going to be stored in the memory. Next, sir, always going to store in the memory. That's why performance wise, okay, next memory point of view, it is always a bigger problem. Sir, if you want to generate a big sequence of values, better to go for generator. In the case of generators, the values are never going to be stored in the memory. Are you getting that? One by one by default you are going to get. Okay, so generators generate a sequence of values, sir, yet runtime based on our requirement. No question of storing this value, storing that value, and so on. Are you? Just very simple, sir. Very simple. I want 1,000 TVs. I want 1,000 TVs, or otherwise 1 lakh TVs I want, sir. 1 lakh TVs I want. There are two approaches are there. What is the first approach? Approach number one. Okay? Array. So that Sony company prepared all the 1 lakh TVs and send to India. Are you getting? Send to Hyderabad. Assume that. Sir, another thing was, we are not going to send any TV. I will send the formula. At runtime, based on your requirement, you can create the TVs one by one, and so on. Okay, so created 1 lakh TVs and send it to Hyderabad is nothing but normal collections concept. Are you getting? Send the formula and based on our requirement. Okay, sir, better to take sir first TV, get a second TV, get a third TV, and so on is nothing but generator concept. I hope, are you able to understand, right? Yes, man. Generator never going to create objects at the beginning. Yet runtime, based on your requirement, it is always going to yield. It is always going to yield first value, second value, third value, something like we are always going to get. Clear for all of right? So generator is a function which is responsible to generate a sequence of values. Remember that, right? Okay. Next, we can write the generator function just like ordinary functions, but it uses yield keyword to return values. So what is the keyword, sir? Can you spell out? I forgot. What is the keyword we require to use? Yield keyword to generate values. Remember this one, sir. It's always going to return the values, but the yield keyword, a special keyword we require to use. The people who are coming from Java background don't map our multi-threading yield concept with the Python yield. Both are completely different terminology, right? Okay, that's all. Next, at very top level, let me go for a small chota example. Sir, memory wise, performance wise, how these are benefit? Yesterday I discussed already, right? Okay. Sir, now what is the a small def? I'm taking def. It is also my gen. Sir, generator is also a function only. Just like decorator, sir. Just like a decorator. Decorator, gen is also, generator is also a function only, right? Sir, this one is going to return yield A. Are you getting? Yield A, yield B, yield C, yield D, something like it's going to return, sir. Yield A, B, C, D, something like A, B, next and after that C, next and after that D, something like this, it's going to return. Everyone can aware? DEF, my gen, yield A, B, C, D. Like this we are going to get. So if I'm getting this gen, this gen is the responsible to provide how many values? Please respond. How many values? Four values, right? Four values won't be stored in the memory, sir. If you can ask, hey, please provide next value, like, then only it's going to provide. Sir, one minute, what we can take? Sir, G is equal to my gen. Now I got the my generator. Sir, this G is generator object, but internally, it is not going to store any value. At runtime, whenever you are going to ask G, can you please provide next value, from this yield list, it is always going to return first value, second value, third value, fourth value. Here order is important, man. Remember that print of type of G, sir. Print of type of G. If any function is going to return yield is there, it is always going to return generator only. Have a look once. What is the object? Which object by default you are going to get, sir? Generator object. Sir, now I want first value. Very simple. What is the next of G? Now I will get the first value A. Regarding first value A. Sir, I want B. Next of G. Next of C. Next of, like, one by one. By default, we are going to get the values. Sir, you can go for list, but the problem with the list is all the four values will be stored in the memory. Unnecessary memory problem, performance problem. But if I can use a generator concept, then automatically, do you know, then happily we are going to get one by one, because the values won't be stored in the memory. So I don't want to get one by one, like iterator. If by using iterator, get one by one. Sir, for x in g, print of x, no problem. Happily it is going to work, man. Have a look once. What is the answer? A, B, C, D, like this. Clear? So memory, next up performance, biggest advantages by default we are going to get with the generators. In the last session somewhere, we covered already. Sir, length of the code is going to increase. Yes, obviously there may be a chance. Length of the code may chance of increase. Maybe a chance. But performance and the length of the code, which is the very critical. Performance and length of the code, which is the very critical. Performance, not length of the code. Remember that. Length of the code is only one time activity. Performance is always critical. If you are going to give the promise, yes, I will provide performance, then I can do anything, man. being a programmer, programmer is always going to think about performance wise only. Okay, that's why even length of the code is going to increase, no problem. Memory problems I won't get, performance problems I won't get. Then obviously generator concept is always recommended. Okay, like, so now one more example I want to tell so that you people can get much clarity, sir. What is my next example, sir? Sir, DEF countdown. Are you getting DEF countdown of num? Are you getting countdown of num? I'm taking, sir. Sir, print of start countdown. Just have a look one, sir. Sir, I'm taking start countdown like this. I'm taking, sir. Start countdown like I'm taking. Can you please start the countdown value, sir? Now while of num greater than zero. Okay, while of num greater than zero, yield is what value I have to return? What value I have to return? Sir, return num. Okay, yield num I have to return. Next, after that, num is equal to num minus 1. So if I call countdown of 10, it is always going to return. It's always going to return first 10, next sir 9, next 8, next 7, like countdown. Are you getting countdown? By default, it's going to return. Sir, is this function is going to return generator or not? Yes, because we use which one? Array, because we use which one? Respond. Because we use which one? Yield. That's why. So yield is going to be, yield is going to generate the number. So if you want to generate next number in the case of generator, which keyword we require to use? Yield is the keyword we require to use, man. Okay, sir. Janacharya, are you able to understand, right? Okay, sir, that's all. Now my requirement is just observe a bit very carefully. Values is equal to countdown. Values is equal to countdown of 5 or countdown of, sir, some 5 I'm taking, sir. Countdown of 5. Now for x in values, can you please print off x? Can you please print off x? Sir, now take a very special care about this terminology, right? Sir, now here have a look once. Start countdown 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. By default, we are going to get or not? Yes, how many values are going to be there in our program? Of course, how many values we are getting? 5 values we are going to get. Sir, now om, take a bit very special care. Especially om k, take a bit very special care. What is my requirement? Yes, array. If I use 5. You have to generate first 5, next 4, next 3, next 2, next 1. So you can store these values inside a list also. Regarding, you can store these values inside a list and now return that list and print the values from the list. One approach. Second approach is, hey, don't store anything. Just return generator. If you can ask that generator at runtime, it's always going to generate first one, second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one, one by one, and so on, right? Sir, now for this program, can I take a list? Is it possible or not? Hey, can I take list? Possible or not? I can take generator also, no problem at all. But which one is always recommended? Sir, generator is always recommended. What is the reason for that? Sir, this generator, okay, if I can use a list, memory waste, performance is going to be down. Yesterday somewhere we covered. Are you able to understand, right? Sir, wherever if you want to return a group of values, if you want to return a group of values without storing these values, highly recommended. Better to go for what? Okay, this what we can use the word, highly recommended to go for generators concept. Okay, like yes. 2 microseconds. Next, Vedant Tiwari, print of countdown of 5 won't work. Yes, it will work, sir. But countdown of 5 is always going to return generator object, but not the values. Remember, if I can use like this, okay, like this. Who is asking this doubt? Vedant Tiwari. If I can use like this, definitely you are going to get yes, generator object, but not values. Observe that. Observe which object we are going to get, sir. Generator object, we are going to get, but not values. If you want the values, sir, just you got formula. By using that formula, better to get one by one. Now, what is the formula? Is equal to countdown of 7. I want, sir. Sir, now you got formula to generate 7 values. Now, for x in values, can you please print of x? Happily, sir, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, by default, you are going to get. Everyone can aware? Next and after that, Vedant Tiwari, have you attended yesterday's session? Yes, yesterday I told, you can use the same thing for the list also. List comprehension, set comprehension, tuple comprehension, we can able to do. But what is the problem? Suppose here you can ask, sir, L is equal to, sir, something like x. For x in range of, five, I'm taking, sir. Okay, like, sir, now for x in L, can you please print off x? Okay, maybe ascending order, it's going to print the value, 1, 2, 3, and so on, like. Can you please observe this approach under this approach? Where is the difference? Which one is the good? Vedant Tiwari, observe a bit very carefully. Sir, here, this one is the very danger. What will happen is, in this line, 5 objects will be created. Those 5 objects will be stored in the memory. Sir, to create 5 objects, to store inside memory, how much time, how much memory, observe that. But in this case, single value also won't be stored in the memory. At runtime, whenever you are asking about first value, second value, third value, at runtime, dynamically, it is going to generate values. Okay? Sir, don't store my values. I want to get one by one at runtime, dynamically. Then happily, we can go for what? Generators concept. Remember this one, sir. Okay? Sir, now, let me go for one more example. One more example, right? Sir, that's all. I'm stopping the session. Okay. Tomorrow we will meet for the continuation. By another 10 minutes, I will complete this one. And then happily we can go for modules concept, right? Okay.